當時嚟深圳時候，見到深圳就係一個好山卡拉嘅地方，即係俾我哋內地一個鎮都比唔到，即係咁講，嗰個環境好差嘅，到處都係農田。
When Wu Tao arrived in Shenzhen 40 years ago, new Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping had just started his far-reaching economic reforms, with the aim of saving the country from disorder and poverty.
I was in 1978, Shenzhen, at the Shenzhen Police Station, the main job was to C港 嘅三趟快車，當時我哋一落車嘅時候就喺路橋附近嗰度落車，一落嚟呢睇到周面都係環山，啊！當時嘅環境我就問嗰個我哋招我哋嚟嘅個阿黃主任，我想個地方咁山嘅，又係咪特區啊？咩深圳特區？我講佢咁幾講，呢個地方以後發展會好快，肯定會好一個現代化城市。那時候呢，七八年時候我就在這個橋，就等於我這個照片一樣。這張照片就說是我，你剛好在這火車頭那裡，79年的時候照的。這旁邊周邊這些景象好像已經全部是變了。
As a guard, Wu witnessed the times Chinese refugees would try to get into Hong Kong via Shenzhen.
79年5月16号嗰天，就係因為好多啲蛇頭放消息講咧，英國女王特赦3天，所以搞到好多東莞、惠州啊、鄰近嘅地方啊，嘅群眾湧過嚟偷渡，以為過去就可以即刻辦到香港身份證。當時你中國嘅經濟話係比較困難，即係講生活係比較貧困，可以咁講得。
After the reform and opening up policies came into effect in the 1980s, it became rarer for people to try to sneak into Hong Kong. It was also at that time that Shenzhen started to grow into a modern city. Zhang Donghong followed the wave of people moving to Shenzhen.
In 1983, 东门老街那家麦当劳在深圳第一家开张的那家麦当劳，我就印象很深刻。那时候当时很轰动啊，整个深圳是很轰动啊，就开了第一家麦当劳。哇，第一天去他们说很多人嘛，说人挤人，就叫不要去啦，就说我们有亲戚去，他就说帮我打包一个包回来给我尝一下，就觉得很新奇，我们从来都没吃过这种就洋食品啊，哈，结果是不好吃的，当时就很失望。
But Shenzhen at that time was still far less developed than neighboring Hong Kong, which was then a British territory. The border between the Chinese and British sides was very closely guarded. The contrast between Hong Kong and China was most obvious in a little village that straddled the border. In this village, Hong Kong and China were separated by Chung Ying Street, or China England Street, where Zhang used to work.
我进了银行之后啊，我就刚好就分到中医街那个办事处那里了嘛。然后我们等于一边是我们的，一边是香港那边的嘛。其实中间就一条路的哈，你跨个脚过去就到香港，它中间什么都没拦的嘛。深圳这边的衣服，因为当时也没什么品牌嘛，就很普通的那种嘛。因为你一比较就有个差距在那里了嘛，就觉得哎，他那边衣服好漂亮哦。就黑色的衣服配黄色的裙子，还有个小披肩，就觉得这个款式很新颖，很特别啊！当时一看到我就赶紧买了这条裙子了。
Born in Shenzhen in the 1990s, Zhang's daughter, Zhong Yian, is a second-generation citizen of the city. She moved to neighboring Hong Kong in 2009 to attend university, and after graduating, stayed on to work there.
我覺得 2009年嘅時候， 香港同埋深圳嘅分別係有嘅，但而家慢慢我覺得深圳同埋香港嘅差距係少咗好多咯。首先人工方面已經慢慢冇曬差距啦。 因為加上我覺得喺深圳生活嗰呢邊course，個生活成本會更加低，咁就會帶嚟一個更加高嘅生活質量。我就會覺得，咁既然喺深圳嘅條件都慢慢慢慢越嚟追上香港嘅話，咁我都可以考慮翻深圳做嘢咯，覺得係。
In just 4 decades, the once rural Shenzhen became one of the largest and most modern cities of China and home to 12 million people.
即使我嚟咗香港咁多年，即係如果遇到啲即係朋友都會同我講，哦，我其實我自己係深圳，但我深圳人嚟嘅。選擇來深圳，我覺得是來對啦，但是我們的想法也是對的，覺得深圳就會發展成一個國際化的大城市，哈，那種現代化的大城市。
Shenzhen's remarkably rapid development also increased living costs. Many young people today struggle to stay afloat, and owning their own property seems like an impossible dream. The metropolis was built by migrants from other parts of China, like Wu and Zhang. But having become one of the most expensive cities to live in China, Shenzhen now must find ways to keep attracting new migrants in the decades ahead.